So my name is Omai Garner, and we are at the UCLA Clinical Microbiology Laboratory. It's an interesting job. So it's a job that really encompasses teaching, research, and clinical responsibilities. And so my clinical responsibilities are to be a lab director. And this is a laboratory that does the infectious disease testing for the UCLA hospital system. Within our clinical laboratory, we have kind of the state-of-the-art devices to offer to our patients for diagnosing things like HIV, bacterial sepsis, you know, any of these various diseases that can cause infectious disease illnesses. My research specifically is to bring that type of testing to the developing world. And so what I do is I make handheld devices. They're called point-of-care devices, and these devices bring this kind of first world level testing to an area where it's not done. I am from Wisconsin, and so I grew up in an area called Racine, Wisconsin. This is just south of Milwaukee. It's a large town for Wisconsin, but it's a small town. I went to high school there, and then after graduating high school, I went to the University of Wisconsin-Madison. And so I did 5 years there, getting a degree in microbiology and human genetics. And then kind of from there, I made this push to move to the West Coast, and a lot of that was driven by the desire for warm weather, I can just say. And so for graduate school, I actually chose University of California, San Diego. And so I went there to get my PhD in biomedical sciences. And then after that, I came up to UCLA for my postdoctoral research fellowship, my postdoctoral clinical fellowship, and then I got hired on as junior faculty here at UCLA. My parents are retired teachers, and so my father is a music teacher, and my mother is a reading specialist. You know, I didn't go into this wanting to be a scientist. And then I saw a movie when I was in high school, and it was called Outbreak. And this was the kind of movie where people got into suits and went into the hot zone. And I saw that, and I thought that that was really exciting. I'm a scientist for a couple of different reasons. One is that I really wanted to find a way to help a large number of people. And I found that science, and especially translational science, where you're creating devices that are able to help people, is really a really straightforward way of working and being satisfied with your job. In addition, I also like the creative aspects of science. I think science can be seen as separate from art. And actually, that's not how scientists look at it. And so there is really, I'm a musician also, and I see there's a lot of tie-ins in the way that I think about science and make my way through scientific exploration creatively. Yeah, so like, that's the device. That's kind of what the device looks like. Like it's a handheld sort of thing, so that's kind of the inside. And so currently the device we're working on is to create a handheld influenza diagnostic device. What we find is that the flu is not really diagnosed through a lot of the world, and this ends up leading to a lot of problems, mortality, you know, a lot of issues that we don't see in the United States. And so we're looking to create a device that will be easy, cost-effective, and able to be used in a field setting for influenza diagnosis. A laboratory is a fun place to be. It's dynamic, which I think makes it such a satisfying career. It is not monotonous. There are always things that are changing within the lab setting. You really never know what direction your problem can go. And so it's really this kind of searching process that I find creatively very satisfying. There is an element of travel. So I do a fair amount of lecturing. And so this lecturing is usually on some of the new devices that we've taken. So I get to go to a lot of places I've never seen before. I'm going to New Orleans at the end of the month. I've ended up in Philadelphia and Boston and Tampa, a lot of different places. Well, I'm excited about kind of my next phase, because really for infectious disease testing, you need to be on the ground in other areas of the world. So, you know, places like Bangladesh, Sub-Saharan Africa, Southeast Asia, South America. These are kind of the next steps for me to go to these places to not only test the device, but also just increase general education. So what we end up doing is we're going to need to aliquot out patient serum into some of these individual tubes so that we're able to then use that diagnostically within some of our handheld devices. And so my hopes and dreams for the device that I'm working on now is that we would be able to bring first world diagnostic medicine, get it into the setting where it's most necessary, and bring down the mortality caused by these viruses. I would say to encourage young people who want to have a career in science is that there is part of the learning process to be a scientist that can be very tedious. And the reason why that process is tedious is because it's very similar to learning a new language. And so you build your base knowledge in science by those classes that you may not find quite as interesting in high school. So chemistry, biology, physics. If you find those classes tedious now, that's okay. There is a light at the end of that tunnel that would allow you to choose anything that you find fascinating.